Hi, I'm David LaChapelle, and you're watching France 24.
From Michael Jackson being held by Jesus.
It was always Mary holding her son, Jesus, and the greatest loss is a mother losing a child. And I felt the world really lost something when we lost Michael. So I have the Pietà pose with Jesus holding Michael in his arms.
To Miley Cyrus, naked and in solitary confinement.
Like 90,000 people in America in solitary confinement. It was, you know, a little bit about how disturbing that is, but also a metaphor as well for the prisons we make in our mind.
Through his iconic photographs, David LaChapelle has made many a celebrity, like Paris Hilton.
I told the editor of Vanity Fair at the time that I wanted to shoot her and her sister, and he's like, why? I said, oh, they're kind of exciting. They dance on tables at restaurants, and they're just wild.
He himself was discovered by Andy Warhol, who gave him a job at his iconic Interview magazine.
This was the last photo taken of Andy. He was about to go in the hospital for kind of a minor surgery, but he wound up dying. I put two Bibles beside his head. A lot of people, what they don't know about Andy is that he went to church every Sunday. And he was working on the series that he was working on when he died was the Last Supper series.
David LaChapelle is in Paris with his new exhibition, Letter to the World, at the Templon Gallery, bringing together his celebrity photos and his new works, showing a fantastical new world.
What are you trying to tell us with this contrast?
Well, one is sort of a document of the world that we live in my eyes, and the sort of confusion and celebrity, the people that make up the world that we live in, the materialism of our world today, you know, because we're living in kind of a times of a lot of turmoil. And then the other part of the gallery is sort of a reply. It's my reply to that. And it's the idea of heaven and or utopia. You know.
You turn celebrity photography into an art form. Just look at this incredible Christmas card of the Kardashians. What do you make of celebrity culture in 2018?
People are kind of gravitating towards material things and celebrity and sort of a replacement of religion in a certain way. That's you know my perspective. Like a lot of these things are sort of replacing, you know, whether it be sports or celebrity or just plain careerism and materialism. It's sort of replacing spirituality.
When I arrived before you, I was looking at this Christmas card. No one looks the same anymore. Everyone looks totally different. When was this, 2013?
3 years ago, four years ago, yeah.
And what about Kim Kardashian then? Because I know you recently worked with her shooting her new makeup range. I've seen the pictures on Instagram. Mm-hmm. What's she like?
I've thought of this photo and the photos that we've done recently more. It's more about, I think, the culture. When I say culture, not just America, but globally, it's more about our obsession with this family, what they represent, and their lifestyle, then it really is about them. This Christmas card especially was really about our obsession with them. They're standing on, you know, 1,000 magazines with that they're on the cover of. I mean, you can't go to a grocery store without seeing one of them on the cover of, you know, of several of the tabloids. And Kim Kardashian has more followers than Barack Obama, President Obama, on her Instagram. So they're having this incredible impact on people. And that's, you know, museums and galleries like to talk about, you know, high culture, low culture. There's really only one culture, and that's what people are looking at.
And you photograph many women of our time, many women who've made a mark on the world, like Madonna, mm-hmm. Lady Gaga, Rose McGowan, Hillary Clinton. Tell us about a woman and who you photographed that really blew you away, a celebrity.
Gosh, I guess there was two. I mean, I was down in South Africa, in Johannesburg, and I got to photograph Helen Suzman and Miriam Makeba. Helen Suzman was a single white vote in Parliament that visited, only member of Parliament ever to visit Nelson Mandela in prison. And the last photo taken before she passed away. And that was really incredible. And then Miriam Makeba was someone I grew up with, Mother Africa. So that was an amazing trip, meeting those two women who, you know, one white, one Jewish and white and very tiny, and Miriam Makeba, you know, fighting for the same cause, you know, shows how we can, you know, believe in the same things and come from completely different backgrounds and races and get along. You know, it was very, that really had an impact on me, and I showed these pictures in my book.
And through your work, you've been involved a lot in LGBT rights. You made a star of Amanda Lepore, one of the first transgender models, but also way back in 1995, you shot the famous Kissing Sailors for Diesel, which was very controversial at the time because it was one of the first ads where we saw gay people kissing.
Right.
What was it like to shoot something that was so controversial in those times?
I wasn't aware of the impact it had until it had really caused this celebration within the gay community, and some people were outraged, and you know, some people thought that I had taken an old photo and superimposed these two guys. So that was kind of a real big compliment to me as a photographer, because it was my art direction and stuff who made it look like D-Day, now 1945. So it showed me the power of photography. You know, advertising can, in the right hands at the right times, be really, you know, really make a statement and be a positive thing and sort of transcend just selling something.
You famously sacked Madonna years ago. Tell us about that.
You know, working with celebrities can be a lot of pressure, and you know, sometimes you can collaborate. It's an amazing collaboration, and there's a mutual respect and mutual creativity that happens, and a camaraderie that happens, and those are the great times, and you really, you know, love being a photographer when you're doing that. And I like to do all types of photography, and shooting celebrities is one thing. The people that make up our world is really interesting to me. And this just was a case where it wasn't really, those things were really not in place. And I was just coming off this big documentary that I had done, and you know, it was kind of time to say no to something. That's all that was. I just had to say no and walk away. And I'd never said no to a job before, you know, because I didn't finish high school. So, you know, I said yes to everything. And then
You were working crazy hours and crazy days.
Yeah, I was living a, you know, very, very hectic life and working a lot, and I couldn't say no to work, and, you know, just always this fear of to not have anything to fall back on, and then, you know, sort of seeing people come and go in the world of that you know, that I occupied, in the world of photography, in the world of, you know, that arts and things, and really just wanting to... wanting to keep my career going. So I said, you know, yes to everything. So
it's hard if someone like Madonna rings you to say, actually, no, isn't it, I guess?
Well, we got started on the job. It wasn't until I was getting screamed at, and I just couldn't take it anymore. I just said, I can't.
Not long after that, you actually packed up and you left.
Right.
And the center of where you were sort of the top of your game, the most called upon photographer probably for celebrities and other work, doing magazine covers and publicity and everything, and you decided that you were going to go and live on a goat farm in Hawaii.
We have 14 goats. It's not really a goat farm, but chickens, and you know, I'm vegetarian, so we don't eat them or anything. But yeah, you know, it was a time to make that change. I wanted to let, you know, young photographers come in and photograph celebrities and those type of things, and I really thought I was done with that. I thought I was actually done with photography, and then a gallery rang and said, would you want a show, you know, in Berlin? And I said, well, I don't shoot celebrities anymore. You can do whatever you want, and that's how I started my career in the beginning in New York City in the 80s, was in galleries before magazines. So that was always my dream, but I really just thought that would never come, you know, that was kind of the end of that one in the 80s when I started working for magazines. So to get this call from a gallery was like a huge opportunity and something I'd always wanted, you know, to be in galleries again, in museums.
And that's so, the work that we see in the rest of the exhibition.
Yeah, and then I got that call, and I was very inspired, and had, you know, 6 months off and living in this beautiful place. It was very inspiring. It looked to me like heaven, what it would look like in my imagination, and started beginning the work on the New World series, is what I call it. This idea of man and nature, sort of living in harmony.
And since you sort of left the center of where everything was going on, and lots of things have changed in America in the last 12 years, like the first black president, and now Donald Trump. And what do you make of all of that when you're sitting in your sort of tranquil like quiet life in Hawaii, watching what's going on in the rest of America?
You know, there's so many things facing us that are very threatening. You know, we look at climate, and we look at the greed that's ruling, seems to be ruling the planet and the decision makers of our time. And there's a difference than there was in our grandparents' time when, you know, there's this threat coming from, feels like so many angles, you know, and a kind of lawlessness and you know, people being just, it seems, meaner with the internet to each other than ever before, you know. And so I think that was also the impetus to making the work that I've done here at this gallery. You know, I just wanted to see man at his best, humanity at its best, and, you know, turn within for some guidance to, you know, a higher consciousness and where people, you know, are living in a harmonious way with the world. And this idea of this new world or heaven was really felt important to put out in the world.
David LaChapelle, thank you very much.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.